What's up, guys? Corey here, getting ready to do a carpet repair here in North Austin. It's another typical dog trying to dig out of a room type repair. I will put the vacuuming portion at the very end of the video. It'll be a smaller vacuuming thing because obviously it's just a repair, but a lot of tufting, kind of a mess. So anyway, let me turn the camera around and show you where I'm starting. All right, this is where the dog tried to dig out. And it looks like he didn't get the wood this time. A lot of times though, it wasn't a pit bull, it was a German Shepherd. Shepherds tend to rip, and pit bulls tend to chew the drywall and chew the doorknob and chew the bottom of the door off and just do all kind of crazy stuff. But German Shepherds are a little better. I've seen them where they tear the carpet back to like right back to here. I mean, they just rip feet and feet of carpet. All right, well, I'm gonna start cutting on some carpet here, and I will update the video here in a little bit because I've got some I gotta set all this up for repair first, so I will be back. All right, I have done a little trim away here. So basically, we got the damage runs to, I believe that's about it there. Unless there's something else I can find back here, and I'm tracking the damage to the furthest most points, and it looks like that's it there, and that's gonna be it over here, it looks like, which challenges the math on my replacement carpet just a little bit. What I'm doing, I was given carpet to repair with, however it's gonna be a swap out here. What I'm doing is I'm confiscating the closet here. I'm gonna take the closet, I'm gonna use that to make the repair with, and then the other carpet that they bought is going to go back into the closet, which is right there. It's just a little bit of difference, probably not enough to really notice that much, but I'd like to keep it as correct as possible. So I haven't done a video with this much in depth in a while because I don't get that many views on carpet repair, but doing it today. I'm gonna follow it up with a vacuuming. So, you know, oftentimes the client takes care of all the vacuuming and all that stuff, and you know, but now since we're such a vacuum crowd, I think I'm gonna do all that from here on out, I believe. All right. I'm gonna do some more cutting, and I will check back in here in a bit, hoping that it should work, but it's getting mighty close when you push that through the doorway, if this guy is gonna meet here. So I do see some margin for trouble yet, and it looks like it almost challenges the length of the whole thing here, but it is gonna make it. It has to go inside that door a little bit too, and probably be cut out a little bit. So anyway, I'll check back in. All right. Where we're at now, I've got everything basically cut out. What I did is I took the piece and I kind of lay it in place where it covers everything, you know, that you need to cover. In this case, it went about this much farther than it needed to go, which is just not a problem, really. I took the entire closet anyway. So I'm going to put a little pad in there, fix that, and then the piece of carpet that's going in there is I drug it over here. It's got those cuts made in it and everything, so I'll show that in place in a minute. I've got to put all the carpet tape under it, and when I come back, everything will be laid in place, and I'll show you how that looks. Okay, everything is set up and ready for me to seam in now, and Frise usually makes the best blend in repairs. You can really barely tell the difference between the carpet out of the closet and the carpet that's been worn quite a bit. I can see it. I don't know if anybody else can, but it blends really well. All right, now this is where the tape is underneath all of it. So getting ready to seam all of this in over here. This is what this looks like. This is the way I've got it cut in, all just to fit perfectly. So now I'm gonna start slowly seaming it in from the top, and I'll show sections of that as I go until we're done here. And then after that, I'll put the carpet back in here, but that won't be part of anything I'll cover, but I'll show when I'm done. All right, moving along. Alrighty, we are maybe halfway done with the repair. I've got this part seamed in here. I'm coming around here, seaming this guy in, taking it all the way around to the wall there. Got a few more placements of the iron to finish it up, and then to cut and tuck everything in, and then the closet. So it's coming along pretty nice. Shouldn't be able to tell the dog ate the carpet up when I'm done. I got nowhere to stand, though. I'm about to trip. All right, got a little video update here. This repair, technically, the seaming part is done. Basically, the only thing to finish this now is to tuck in and cut off the remainder of the carpet. What I do at this point is I let this rest for a bit. You want to make sure that all of the glue on the tape is cooled and in place. And while that is happening, that's when I put the closet back in and give this guy time to cool off. Then when I get done with this, I cut that off and we're done. And then I do a little vacuum up and off to the next one, basically. And the plan is always to leave with another 5-star review. That's the goal every time, is to have a completely satisfied customer and have a 5-star review and all good feelings. You know, the carpet getting torn up is a bad thing, but having a guy show up that can fix it at a reasonable rate and leave you looking brand new again, all well. So I enjoy being people's hero. That's what I still enjoy about this job. I get to brighten people's day. When they think the carpet's destroyed, I can come and fix it. Save the day. We are complete now. We have got a carpet repair done to where anybody can see it. Frise is the most forgiving to repair. And it would take somebody really picky to go, well, the closet doesn't match. Nobody really cares about that. I generally have my client pick up the carpet before I get here, so that way they are comfortable with whatever they choose to go in their closet. Works better that way. I'm just a guy. I don't understand colors and stuff like that real well, and I can't match clothes all that well. But I argue with about, you know, black versus navy. It looks like the same to me. Anyway, the repair is done now. Getting ready to vacuum it all up with Sanitaire. So if you don't like vacuum videos, now is your chance to click off the video. Here comes the vacuum part that everybody likes. case anybody wanted to know how these repairs hold up to a vacuum, they do it really well. All right, guys, that concludes this carpet repair video. I've got another one to do across town, so I don't know exactly what it looks like yet. I don't remember what it looks like yet. So I'm going to go over and fix it just like I fixed this one, and I'll have the video up following this one later tonight. Thanks for watching, guys. If you have questions, you're always welcome to text 512-350-1129. If you're in Austin or around Austin, I'm available to come out and clean or repair your carpet or clean your tile or whatever you need. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless.